Alright, well, welcome back to the stream. I'm Poop Rat. And, gonna be doing some more Shadowrun Returns. Playing as, no game, what the fuck? Load her up. Continue, the adventures of Lady Elf. I will say I do not remember any of the voices I gave to any of the characters, so they are bound to be a lot different now. Alright, I don't remember any of the voices. How else may I be of service? Yes, Mr. Lila's in the back bar. That's usually where he does business. What even is my quest right now? Okay, up there. Alright. Yes, head on out to the streets. What's the guard? Guard looks bored, he toys with his gun. Absentmindedly, like he might shoot something on a whim just to watch it die.
Hey! You're about to trespass on corporate property. You look to get dusted, street scum.
Working with Lone Star on the crime scene investigation.
Here you are. I'm Offrey, the King of Dragons. Free!
What do you got, Streetwalker? Sexy, y'all. Oh. Alright, not me, a friend of mine. I need you to have fun with the guard on the fence around the corner. Alright. Alright, $20. Alright, $20. You have a 5-minute distraction. And I gotta get back to work and earn some real moon. How the fuck do I get in? Hmm. I'm gonna just waste my fucking money. Oh, we gotta talk to this motherfucker. And if I can click on. Can't go there.
Who raised you? A pack of wolves, started in a ladder, rapidly mine. Alright, break it into NTS, be warehouse too. You see any of them airplane blankets and pillows, snag me with them. Okay. Alrighty. Anything. Know what I'm looking for. But I do see shit to loop over here. Press the screen. Into my stash. What we got over here? Into my stash. Alright, let's head inside. That's an interesting location, yes. Took your sweet time, didn't you? You know the traffic. We had time to go over the evidence while you were en route. Turns out this might not be a ripped murder after all. Left the computer on in the office over there if you want to see it for yourself. The victim worked there at the NTSB warehouse as a black box researcher. National Transportation Safety Board. This warehouse is used to go over the wreckage from plane crashes to try to determine what happened. Vic was in charge of their highest priority investigation at the moment. We've gone through the victim's computer and his case notes indicate he was selling secrets. Idiot kept records. Tell me about it. Some runner like you probably offered him to cover up his corpse master's involvement. Tried to make it look like a ripper killing. Here's the office key. Check it out for yourself if you want. Dresden, that's it. There you go. Proud to see you here. Let me guess, Officer Aguirre. Get the office. Suppose you must have made an impression on him at the market yesterday. Or your credit stick did, at any rate. Anyway, surprise. Got another ripper victim on our hands. Victim's male, mixed Native American descent, age 38. based on the condition of the body, it looked like he was killed around 2 in the morning. Cause of death unknown. Several internal organs were removed from his body after death. Quite gruesomely. Not sure if the killer even knew what they wanted before they started cutting. How much else to tell you, really? He does have a lot of pre-existing scar tissue, so he probably had a major surgery at some point in recent history. Fortunately, with the organs on, I can't determine the nature of the surgery. Well, the killer definitely took the lungs. The more I look at it, though, the other missing organs may just be eviscerated in the chest cavity. Cluster could have found his ass with both hands. Don't tell him I said that, though. Guire would love to solve it for him, Cluster. And get his good detective shield. His gold detective shield. Plus, he'd love to see McCluskey suck it in front of his superiors. He's already tried to bribe me to keep information from McCluskey and slip it to him. I'm inspired by their tireless pursuit of justice. Do you have any idea how much this job pays these days, ma'am? I don't think Aguirre's officer's salary is going to do much to seduce me into helping him. Sorry, I don't do theories. I'm just a scientist who happens to prefer dead people. However, while there was massive damage to the chest cavity, I could see that the victim's lungs were transplants, which is interesting since another victim's missing heart was also a transplant. Random amount of medicine has made organ transplants relatively easy, but this is an odd coincidence. But as a scientist, it's just that, a coincidence. This is only the third body I've personally examined. One of our other branch managers handled the other two. Find that more of the victims had organ transplants, I'll let you know. How close you showed up next weekend, I think. Good luck out there. And in half sky.
You're not a cop. I'm independent, which relates to the dead man. Suspicion in your voice and eyes departs almost instantly when the subject turns to the deceased. He's my brother. I've been trying to speak with him. But I've heard his spirit is too disoriented by his recent journey to answer me.
A shaman.
Yes, for all the good it's doing me. If I could just make contact, I might be able to deliver justice and allow my brother's spirit to rest. Not so far as I can tell. Not among the living, anyway. Realization then dawns, brings the light back into her eyes. My brother's spirit may not be alone here this night. Close her eyes and concentrate. Droning a low chant,
you can barely hear.
Yes, there are others. Other spirits who may be of help. Features harden in frustration, as if she's searching for something that remains elusive. Sighing, she opens her eyes, fixes you with a stare. But I can't do it alone. What do you need? The warehouse contains the spirits of plane crash victims trapped between worlds. They wish to help. They wish to be heard. I think they have something to say about my brother's murder. Lone Star won't let me in there, but you see, seem to have the run of the place. You can find personal items that belong to the victims. I believe that I'm summoning a spirit to speak with us. Need to at least 2 such objects. Can you find them for me? But I can. Let's look around a bit. What we got here? The old post pigs. That'll have him posing with an assault rifle. Alright, What's there to steal here? Large pile of old shoes on the ground next to the airplane seat. Could be discarded luggage or possibly shoes worn by occupants of the plane at the time of crash. Dig through. Going through the shoes, you realize that there are three shoes with no matching pair. A left blue sneaker, a right high heel pump, and a left black dress shoe. Dress shoe is a black lace up with a rubber sole. Pump is a department store knockoff of an Italian brand. It is otherwise unremarkable. Sneaker is a child's and has musty, sweaty smell. Oddly, you get a sort of shock as if from static electricity when you touch it. Must be one of the items the shaman was looking for. You take the shoe. Where would you get, pal? It's hard to say whether this is a heap of items and refuse recovered from a plane crash or simply trash that hasn't been taken out yet. Sticky substance from some sort seems to have seeped through the trash pile. Your hands are quickly covered with stuff. Searching for a minute, you unearth a handful of interesting items. Earring. Earring is made out of burnished steel, formed into the shape of a small salmon. An intense primal fear washes over you as you touch its surface. This must be one of the items. Shaman to you. What's about this? Dented tin lunchbox that's seen better days. Barely make out the face of a grinning troll on the front. Brian the credit stick is still functional. You slide it into your PDA and 2,000 new yen is added to your account. Alright. Well, shaman lady, got your shit. Feels as though you have found enough objects. Hand her the objects you found, she closes her eyes and chants over them for a time. Her eyes open again, they're filled with tears. Thank you. These items are all I will need. It shouldn't take me long to...
What the hell is all this?
Is the victim sick? Sister, sir, she...
This is a crime scene, officer. Not some Dallas Grub circle.
It's Senator Protocol to contact next kin.
Ma'am, consider yourself contacted. I get the hell out.
Come on, if we stay much longer, I'm liable to do something I regret, worth something I'd enjoy. Oh shit, I forgot to check the computer. Fuck. That man is an ass. There's daggers at McCluskey from across the warehouse. There's no helping you now. I should just be grateful you were able to collect these items before those clods carted everything off. You still summon the spirit? Not from here, I'm afraid. Spirits such as these have domains to which they are anchored. We need to get back in there. Looks like these won't tie up the place for long. Looking good now, but we have our plans for this evening. Right. Agreed. I expect it will be clear by nightfall. You sure you're up for this? If your brother's killer doesn't take another life, then yes. Thank you. Now, since we have the time, we should probably enlist some help. They may post security overnight. I'm going to go out on a limb and say you know where to find the kinds of people we need. Good. I'll put up the money if you find the bodies. Produce a fistful of crumpled nuyen from inside a leather pouch. Starts to count it out and shoves the whole wad at you. Meet me back here at midnight. The spirits will be strong then. Start to leave the warehouse, your comic trips, and the face of Cutie Pops on the screen.
Boy, Lydia,
you in the middle of something? I hear you. I don't know if I ever told you this, but I was born in the Royale. BTL pushers like Stevie J ran the squats. Ran my world when I was growing up. Looks really whiz. I have a cousin, Gino. Been missing for months. He hit the sprawl about a year ago and immediately fell in with some tweakers. Bad guys. They hooked him on high amp dream chips and started using him for all sorts of drugs. Used to help him, but he pushed me away. Then he disappeared. I've been shooting up BTL labs ever since, trying to find him. Guess you have a new lead? It's not a lead. Race lights up. Running hot. Has a serious edge. I know exactly where he is this time. Got an old friend who eyeballed him herself. I'm on my way. Pac was with me, but we could use another hand. You in? I need you right now. I knew you'd come. I'll send you the address. See you soon. Thanks for meeting us, Lady F. I owe you one. No sweat, I figured you could use backup. If you can find a way to make this pay off. Alright. Yeah, you never know what sort of firepower to expect in one of these BTL squads. Bretons. Oh, hey, listen. I got good news for you. You know Sam's sister, Jessica? One of my contacts found her for me. While you were on your way here. I called her and asked her to meet you at the union later today. Hope that helps. Chad, thanks. Looks at you. Scarred face soft. Least I can do. Alright, let's get this done. My cousin Gino should be in one of the squats past that door overhead. Here's a whole lab set up in there. In my experience, there's usually a lookout watching for cops outside and a guard at the door inside. Like I said, don't know how much firepower to expect, that these guys are nasty, so stay on guard. Just want to get in, grab Gino, and get out. I'm right behind you, babe. Let's do this. Alright, what we got here? Detail clocker. York looks twitchy, his eyes rolling in his head, he scans the three of you, looks past to see if there are any others, licks his lips, nods throughout as if going through some internal checklist.
Boy, boy, how you doing? Good day for a trip, ain't it?
Glenn's whispers in ears. This guy's a clocker. Trades work time for chips. Part salesman, part lookout. Probably has a signal device for the guys inside.
You wanna go on a ride? I'll see you around after this. Probably see you lots.
Got Charlie over there. Concerned woman in the loop. More concerned woman, what do you got? The woman is probably in her 30s, but hard times have aged her. She looks at you with concern. Don't do it, friends. Don't slot that drug they're selling. BTLs are killers. There's more. There's most of all. I like you know from experience. Pulls her hair back to show you, no implant. Then her mouth tightens and her eyes well up with tears. I do, I know. Lost my husband, lost my son, my daughter. They use her to record. She streamed down her face. looks around, frightened, whispers, "That's serious. This place is backed by the Yakuza.
Japanese mafia. Oh man.
Many of what kind of firepower? There's a guy on the door, Charlie. He sells the passes to get in. He's not tough, blind in one eye. There's another five or so wandering around. Two of them are bad news. Covering magic symbols. Mean.
Zamped ready. Five or six? That's not so bad. We have surprise on our side.
Who doesn't? He's here all the time. Gino's a clocker. Trades time for chips. Like their little errand boy. I saw him go in there this morning. Hasn't come out, so I imagine he's riding a dream ship. Ship all day, all night. And they can be dangerous, too. Once someone's ship, they can send them any program they want. Make them do whatever. Turn them into whores, killers, anything. No, just Jamal was my son's card. Took it off him when his brain fried. Jamal's down the hall. Don't know if he'll give it up, but that's between you and him.
Alright, Jamal. Where you at? You Jamal, alright, you got anything to fucking steal?
Alright. Jamal's the look of a longtime chiphead. Minty-eyed, hollow-eyed, but hungry and desperate.
What you looking at, Spraggy?
Do you have a good?
You hear right, I got a few. I sell my discount. Charge 50 new ones for them, but I can get you 3 for $100.
I was looking to a person.
This is the band, homie. You want, you take it.
Wake that girl's head in.
Ah, of course. Alright.
Right, Parker, go beat this guy.
Oh shit! All right. Where's your girl? All right, there you go. Dune and Dune.
Pick up a worn and mangled notebook. It smells of sweat and alcohol.
Notebook contains lists of illegal Simpsons rides and the name of clients who have purchased them. Better than life rides run the
gamut from panties like I Can Fly, real life recordings such as Bum Killer. List of rides doesn't seem to have much value. On further examination, the client list is more than a simple list of names. It also contains private information about some of the more well-to-do or connected clientele. Maybe that the syndicate behind this lab is directing certain clients here to secretly extract information from them while they are under the influence. Take that. Let's see. Dun, dun, dun. And then and then. Nope. Alright, in we goes. There's more people need killing. The entire floor of this tenement has been given over to a chaos of technology and squalor. Across the room, a chromed out decker argues loudly with an armed thug, abruptly falling silently as they turn towards you. Shotgun wielding thug squeaks and panics.
Crew that took out Stevie J's place. Told you it was only a matter of time.
Man with the cyber deck calmly speaks with a heavily digitized voice.
You mess with the wrong BTR lab, ahoy. This is a Yakuza operation. With a push of a button, I can make these tweakers into my own personal killer puppets. You're fragged.
Lydia, don't attack any of the chip bits. They don't know what they're doing. And you could hurt Gino. I have a concussion grenade. Better than fragging the tweakers if they get caught in the middle.
Alright, so which ones are, tweak, okay, detail operative, security, okay, chip head, okay. Okay, never mind. Right here's. Oh, that takes two, okay. I just had to one of them. Alright. What are you chanting, girly? All right.
shaman down. That guy's down. And go to reload. Do this for right now. There's move you over here. Up there's
I might fucking kill him though. Fuck are you, dude? Standing there, shit. Alright, fuck it, so I think I can't do. It's hoping wind him down, but whatever. Check the BTL Gina's been riding, he gasps suddenly and his eyes flutter open. He looks fused, worse than the other chip heads you've seen. Lips are white and chapped, eyes sunk into his head. There's vomit on his shirt and sweat on his forehead. When he speaks, his words are slurred. He's burnt. What the hell? You slotted me out. You freaking slotted me out. Everybody is shaking, she looks horrified. Gino, it's me, Kyla. Gino looks at her with gazed eyes, no recognition. Let me back in, goddammit. This is bullshit. I don't want to be here anymore. Let me back in. Looks around the room angrily. Dan reaches for his implant. Kid grabs his wrist, stops him. Gino, no. Coyote, be careful. Gino wrenches his wrist from Coyote's grasp, and he staggers back, reaching under his shirt and pulls out a gun. Coyote watches him horrified. Tears in her eyes, Gina waves it around, blinking wildly. Back off. Back the hell off. Presses his head to the side of his head, his fingers still on the trigger, squids. No. We gotta slide back here. Get away from this track. It's tickling your brain. Oh, isn't it better than life? Sucking your life, wasting my world. Reality sucks, but at least it's real. You can touch it. Yeah, what? Wasting guy. He looks around at the scholar of the room, glimpses his own reflection in the machinery. No. A Yodi shouts on, but it's too late. Gino jams the gun into his jade and pulls the trigger. There's a pop, barely gunshot, and he's gone. I'm sorry, Carla. I'm so sorry. She looks at you, tears in her eyes. I'm not stopping. Not now, not ever. Looks at Paco, then back at you. A real rain is coming to Seattle. It's gonna wash the scum off the streets. I'm gonna burn every mother fragging BTL shop in the sprawl. So they are gone. Every mother fragging one. It probably could have got better. Do not knows. Picture of spell the hang runners. Gino flies down,
walk to the door.
Hey, Al. There's a woman looking for you. Jessica something. She's waiting for you by the stage. Bellevue type. Wouldn't order anything. Won't touch anything. Think she's afraid of disease or something. No charge, tumor. You don't get much action in the early afternoon, just a few salarymen slumming. Tourisville is off, hoping to talk to Madame Sinful, some diehard regulars. That's what the downtown folks call Miss Kabuta. It's a Tourisville thing, they like her to have not a name like that.
I just got in, but I think I just cleaned the back bar. Mr. Delilah is hanging out in his usual place. The vendors downstairs came in a few minutes later, minutes after me. Oh, and Bartlett's here. I don't think you've met him yet. John Bartlett. Big presence at the end of the bar. He's in the biz, connected. You might want to meet him. Me and my ex, Shane. No. He hasn't been in since last time. No calls or pages or handwritten notes either. Weird. He was so persistent. Guess he finally got the message. Maybe he'll find someone at the Universal Brotherhood of his settle down. Have fun. John Bartlett, I guess. John, see what you about. Boulevard, with a quick smile, the man tilts his head and watches you approach.
Hey lady, what's shaking?
Little this, little that.
I hear that, homie. Might have something for you. You got the new one.
Money.
You ever hear of the Nephilim Network?
Of course you have.
And an old lady like you has to have heard of the Premier Merc team out there.
Yeah, sure I have.
Do you know you can hire us to run with you when you need expert help? Not just any tube calling himself runner. We cost more, but we're worth it.
Aunt Jessica? Glance, you could tell that Sam's sister Jessica is from a different world, the opposite of Sam in almost every way. Suit is tailored, her eyes are sharp, and her style exudes authority. Watts, Jessica Watts. Jives you up and down there warily, does a good job of hiding it. Yeah, but it is clear that she is well outside of her comfort zone.
Yes? And you are?
Better off, I'm looking to your brother Sam to death.
That's funny. I didn't think Sam had any friends.
And a little differently in the shadows.
Because it would have to be. So you're the one I was told about on the phone? Woman who called herself Coyote contacted me this morning to inform me that my brother was dead. That I should come to this place and speak to someone about an investigation.
Alright, so I was hoping to help you get to the bottom of this.
I don't know what all. What use I'll be.
Answer a few questions, all.
Alright, but.
Then furrows her brows regarding you more critically.
You're not with the police, are you?
I look on her face, she's clearly struggling with this.
I'll be honest. I'll just as soon put this all behind me, and the fastest way to do that is through proper channels. Surely there's an official police investigation going on. Why not let the professionals handle this? But you must have better things to do than waste your time searching for whoever killed my low-life brother.
Oh, this kind of payday. First Sam was in front of second, being paid for my trouble. Seemed genuinely surprised.
Someone's paid you? Find it hard to believe that someone who really knew Sam would put up the money. Who is it? I don't understand. Hard to believe that my drunken thought up a brother hired you to find the person who killed him after he died.
Boredom mask drops momentarily and in a sigh she reveals a brief glimpse of real emotion.
I left Seattle to get away from Sam and his bullshit. Now I'm back, he's dead, and I still have to deal with him.
Jessica composed herself and in a breath the mask is back in place.
Listen to me, Lady Elf. You seem like a decent person, but I'm trying to move on with my life. My mother killed herself last year, and Sam was Sam, you know. I've worked so hard to put my family issues behind me. I don't want to see this drag on.
I've nothing more to give you closure, and quickly.
I appreciate that, but I think I'd prefer to just let it be. No one else needs to get hurt. Are we talking about the same man? My brother was worthless, Lydia. Worthless. He used to be, but he...
She's done.
Never mind. I can see that you are not going to let this go, and I respect that you are honoring my brother's memory in your own way. But I hope you can understand how emotional this is for me.
It's because demeanor instantly changes from reluctant to helpful in the span of a single meditative breath.
Maybe you can do things in a way that the police can't, and maybe I can help. What do you need from me? It's been ages. I can't even remember. I wrote many such notes in the beginning, but I haven't made such an effort in a long time now. I don't know why he would have kept it. I will overlook the implied accusation and tell you that I was at a fundraiser all evening. Very crowded fundraiser. Sam's biggest enemy was Sam. I don't know of any others. He was actually no better than me these days. I think I made my feelings about Sam pretty clear, don't you? I mourned losing Sam long before he died.
This kid takes a photo from you, guardedly as if it might sting her, but that guy drops the most quickly.
Where did you find this? I can't believe you kept this.
She does the old photo for several silent moments. What happened between the two?
Things were different back then. We were different. We were a family. Then after our father died, things began to change, and we couldn't get back to a new normal. With our dad around, there was always a reassuring order to our lives, but after everything got mixed up, you can never really appreciate the importance of a person in your life until they're gone.
Remorse plays wet across her face, and it seems she's not just talking about her father. Best to go and steal herself to tell the rest.
Sam tried to be the man of the house, he truly did, but he couldn't handle it. Pretty soon he had every dime of our father's life insurance, every dime. After that, was gone. With mom working 2-3 jobs, he spent all her money too. I couldn't stand the way he abused her trust, so finally, I just had to leave.
Held the forward photo, one part of her ready to relinquish it along with the past, and another looking to hold it on to both.
May I keep this?
Please do.
Thank you. He was a devout Catholic. I don't think it's an exaggeration to say that she sacrificed her life for Sam and me. But she turned a blind eye to what Sam was becoming, refused to acknowledge his downward slide. I couldn't watch her do it anymore, and so I moved out.
I fucking know how that is.
After I left, we drifted further and further apart. I wasn't here when she died. In fact, I didn't even know about it until I returned to Seattle 5 months ago. Calvary. It was less what brought me there and what made me leave here. I felt lost in Seattle, so I moved to California to see if I could find myself.
Did you?
Actually, yes. While I was there, I developed a whole new outlook on life, a vision for what the world could become, and I came back here to help make it happen.
Thank you.
Just swear I need to get back to the office. Before I go, you should know this. I'm reiterating my mother's body. Reinterring my mother's body tomorrow. I'm arranging to have Sam buried with her. The funeral's tomorrow at Our Lady of the Blessed Sacrament. 7 o'clock. You're more than welcome to attend.
Wouldn't miss it.
Goodbye, Lady Elf. I hope you find what you're looking for. Stay safe.
Okay. What else I got? Alright, to the picture of our hiring runners. Okay. Oh, got some karma. Hold on. Okay. Enemies. That's a good enemy computer browser for Decker. Still not special, but okay. Go and get that one. And go with somebody. And the one net decking up as well. Oh, all right. Wiping down the back bar, she doesn't stop when you approach, keeps her eyes on her work. Hey. Hey, you okay?
Yep, fine. Listen, Lady F, I don't want to talk about what happened with Gina, okay? What's done is done. Gina's dead, I'm alive. That's all there is to it. It's the Barons, right? Nothing more to do or say. I'm gonna be looking for work, your kind of work, so something comes up, keep me on my mind.
I will.
Okay, I gotta do this now. The afternoon checklist isn't gonna finish itself.
Alright, Mr. Delilah.
You're talking to me, there's business to transact, am I right?
That's right,
Dad. To be right.
Should you have to be right. It's always miserable for me.
I appreciate this about you. Street talk is that you are a dangerous individual. What can I do for you, dangerous individual? You got scratchy just planning to pay me out of your earnings. Excellent. We agree on terms. I've got some runners on call if you've got any special requests. Okay, alright, let's see.
God damn, you guys. Look. Lance's sons of bitches.
So we got a shaman, mage. Johnny boy.
All right, that's the will of the rigger.
Yeah, they're so Nova hot, they prove there's beauty in the power of the machine. Hey, ducker, ducker. Anything is dangerous. Heat of perfection is a balance of mind and body. Defense hurt them where it's where they're vulnerable. Defense, get out of the way. These are the data people try to hide, and he takes it. It could be yours for a price. Drugs and bites, nodes and IC, the lifeblood of a Decker. Some drug like that. Take this dude. And I get a rubber. Roll two, load it. Roll three, kill everything. Your last fragment water that. Helps squash things smaller than he is. Bonus killing things larger too. Got a shaman, so don't need that. Got a mage, don't need that. Need a damage dealer, so Samurai is pretty expensive, as is the Adept. Alright. Go H2O. Party's runs to meet Shannon, yep. I always bring H2O with you. Okay, take that. Dirt. Awesome, increases quickness and AP. Dark gains one armor. Okay. Yeah, fuck it, let's take everything. About time he showed up. Looks like we weren't the only ones who wanted to take advantage of the situation. A bunch of mercs flocked down the air. I don't think they're here for us, though. I guess there's something worth a bit of coin left in that warehouse. Probably not. They've been doing regular patrols around the perimeter. The front door looks like it's locked. Alright.
You there. This block is all rivets. There's we've got a cash leak on the docks here. No loitering.
This guy doesn't look like one of the hired mercenaries.
Hey, are you listening? Get out of here.
Really, guy? They aren't paying enough, especially not once Lone Star sends a response team.
Rag, an issue's locked. Tell me they jammed all the Lone Star channels. Damn it, I'm out.
Yeah, makes it a little easier. Alright, got dead fucking people's abouts. Interact with anything that...
And right, let's kill the area.
There, what do you got?
Man about that dude.
What are you capable of, buddy? Mark's enemy causing him to become easier to hit. Shadowrunner. Really, you fucking missed? Pretty good, Vist. Manifest, pop magic punch. Arm damage increases. Magic resistance. Hit did good. Missed, really? Suck, dude. Fucking watery ass fucking hands thrown shit. Yeah, guys. Summoner. I guess then good. Hold that game. Really? Your wounds real quick, lady. Take care. Haste to you. Rest these fuckers. Really? Man, a bolt. soon as the last bird hits the ground, the dock goes eerily quiet. Really silent beat. Alright, got the key. Alright, let's get in here. Pity the brothers are after. All right, I'm just oh, shit. Fire on you. Yeah. Oh, not done yet. Who's left? someone over here. Take it. Are they down there? Himself up. Shitty amount of fucking health. Damage on the most recent attack. Myself some armor instead, I guess. Oh, my guys in here first. Oh, let's hit him. That was nice. How can I use this? Oh, team it to life. Okay. give up something, but really. I want to fucking, mana bolt him. Flight recorder. I'm gonna look at some shit first real quick. Try to come in here and steals. Alright, never mind. Over back here though. Nothing to fucking take. Oh shit, alright. Kind of a fucking warehouse doesn't have shit to steal. Alright, let's continue. Got some in the spirit. The air grows cold and the spirits of dead children coalesce in the vapor of your breath. Their cherubic faces are burned and their lips quiver as if they are about to cry. Their eyes are round and vacant. They glare at you, unblinking.
Where are the innocents who have perished in the flames, choking on smoke? As we fell from the sky crying for our mothers, you bring anchors to your world, which was once home to us, and we will use them to testify. We no longer see the world of flesh, seeker, only the essence and aura of living things. Words, though. Words may echo through the veil. Sometimes we may hear them. Last night this place was filled with a scream that went on and on, drawing us to it. It was a man crying out for a witness as he died. So we came to bear witness, but fled in terror of a father malevolent spirit that profaned the man's remains. This spirit was other. It was not of this place. It had twisted its way through the veil and through the dark to come here. When the other had gone and we returned to our vigil, we found two creatures of flesh. One, he would call an elf, unsullied by technology and able to channel the energies of the cosmos. Yet his spirit was corrupted from within. He was dark and twisted, yet not like the other, so he did not flee. The second we knew to be a troll. Ribbons of his essence had been flayed from him, leaving cold machinery behind. His aura was the aura of one simple and confused. Between elf and troll lay the remains of the man whose sister now chants to us for justice. The elf, his essence remains in this place where the man died. Something has been left behind. A small part of him, perhaps.
Spirits begin to fade. All but one. Its eyes harden. It takes full measure of you. As if to commit everything about you to memory.
No, we must not stay.
Spirit gone. The young shaman releases her hold on the magical tether, connecting her to the other rope.
She reels from the backlash, her hands from the emotional
toll of knowing her brother's last moments. They saw him. They were with him when he died. You alright? Takes a series of controlled breaths, only shuddering with the first few.
No, but I will be.
I don't want them, that for him. Not what those poor souls have endured. My brother deserves to be free. Yes, the elf and the troll. We are to find that place. Peace of the elf the spirit spoke of. It's our best hope of stopping this.
What we got?
Blood, this is what the spirits wanted us to find, the piece of my brother's killer. Not much, but it's enough. Yells at it, looking every bit like she intends to reach through the small sample and
dismember her tone from afar, but perhaps she can.
And perhaps she can. Is that enough to target a spell? I can, given enough time. I'm still feeling quite drained. I'll need to rest before I can try anything so involved. When I'm able, I'll commune with Bear, consult the spirits, and do what must be done. But in the meantime, Yuma might take some portion of the sample to pursue a more conventional avenue of attack. Friends, good. Let me know if you learn anything about this self-control pair. Should you find them, I want to be there when they are brought low. I want to see the light leave their eyes for my brother. Can't get in here. Hold on, you got a call? We'll be right back.
Alright, I'm back. Yeah, take a phone call real quick. Alright, now, get on out of here. Watch a couple staff, cash person, posing tourists, and Thieves Hollow. My bar and lounge are deserted except for a handful of janitors. Gathering around the intimate back bar, Miss Kabuta, or Kotor. Whatever, gather for breakfast. The lady herself doing the cooking. The smell of soy calf and something. Okay, never mind. Me not reach so fast. In the sausage. Clue.
Evening, ma'am.
Good around town, Mr. Clue.
Been more talk with the Ripper Kitty. Some people are saying they hate crimes on account of the victims all being human. My thoughts exactly. People are just too quick to label something a hate crime. Check the census, the city is just 66% human. Close your eyes and throw a rock, more than likely to hit a human. Doesn't make it a hate crime. Still a crime though, and that should be enough.
First real rise you've seen out of Mr. Clue. Buddy reins himself in with a roll of his thick shoulders and a smoothing of his jacket.
Don't worry, not gonna start throwing rocks. Wouldn't want to reinforce the stereotype. Leave it to your business, ma'am.
Ohio. Would you like some? Stop, forgive me. Oh my. You look like hell.
Oh, no. Nah.
Looks you over, noting the signs of your nocturnal activity. She nods. Any run you can walk away from is a good run. It's good to have you back. I could tell you have been busy, and I could see by the look on your face that there's something you need. This about the Ripper. That is excellent. I will unlock the piano so you can go downstairs. You may go downstairs. I'm certain someone in the safe house will be able to help you. They are away. It's likely that you will visit the Matrix before the day is done. Now take a sausage. Take the whole plate. Fry. Morning, you look like you've been up all night. I think I gave him a fucking more suave voice than that.
You look like you've seen some action too.
Alright. You here to buy equipment?
Need dinner. Rockin' over you out.
Not Castle's equipment isn't really set up for that. Just for a minute. However, I could employ a semiconductor chip. It could decode DNA using a voltage change instead of light.
That would eliminate the use of highly expensive equipment that would be required otherwise.
Right.
I just wrote a journal about it, so the information's still fresh. Frankly, it should be easy. What do you want to know about?
And his identity.
Ah, that's beyond me. All I can get you is the gene code sequence.
That's where I come in. Yeah, if you can get me that code sequence, I'm pretty sure we can track its owner down via the matrix run.
Will do. Let me have the DNA. You want the test?
Grab the blood sample.
Right now, David gives me the sequence. I'll jack in and help you trace the blood sample back to its source.
No drug? Wake up, Johnny boy. Got work to do. Lady F, you need any gear? I'll be right here.
Just got a second wind. Meet you at my rig, Lady F.
Anything in storage?
Not a notch. Mark some gears.
Need some hardware or software?
Yeah, you're not merchant I need.
Fighting grass, what you doing here, buddy?
Hoping to get some peace and quiet tonight.
You got something for me? Wouldn't have to be an Aries flight recorder, would it? Better pop the bars are looking for that right now. I can get rid of it. Of it for you. You say 20%, that leaves 2,000 for you. Pleasure doing business.
Alright, Johnny boy, let's get this here on the road, shall we?
Thanks to the semiconductor based gene sequencing system that David employed, we should have the information we need to track the Ripper in the Matrix. I'm really impressed with his results, considering it was his first attempt. He was utilizing an unproven technique he'd read about in the Science Journal, and he was working from memory on minimal sleep.
Yes, maybe we can sit down, David, and he can share his research. Let's stay focused. Here's what I'm thinking. We hit the Lone Star DNA database first to see if our donor has a prior criminal record. They have extensive DNA archives. Then we go hunting based on what we find. Let's hit the decks and track into the majors. I can get into their private grid easily, but I've got to warn you. Once we're in, it could get a little rough. How much deck experience have you had?
At noon.
Okay.
Jacking it.
All right. Yeah, that's good.
Okay. Your snaps is light up as you connect your consciousness to the digital world. Though you aren't jacked in like Johnny, the sensation is overwhelming and electrifying. You can only imagine the way it feels for him. That's okay.
Data store head is defended by intrusive countermeasures.
Okay.
How does this shit work?
Hey, sniffer, Emmys. Off attack program, tricked at one target. It's an attacker expert assistant program.
Okay, let's use that. And you. Okay. Interesting mechanics here. Side of you. Quick heal up. Not too bad. This is down. All right. New match located. 100% match. Watch for records database. Subject: Silas Forsberg, deceased. Profession: laptop surgical assistant. Breaking and entering. Public indecency. Brought in for questioning on accusations of unlicensed plastic surgery. No charges were filed. But dead man, let's keep looking. Okay, over here, I guess. Interesting. All right. Turn on subjects. Silas Forsberg. Body of Silas Forsberg. A chop chop surgical assistant was found. Apartment in Nohomish earlier this week. Body had been there for as long as a month. And Forsberg landlord noticed the rancid smell and contacted authorities. Lone Star representatives have issued a statement saying Forsberg's death has been ruled suicide, according to reports. Body and mass of puncture wounds, and the cause of death was determined to be an overdose of anti-stress medications and sedatives. The man's employer claims he was a dedicated employee, though he suffered from bouts of depression. Forsberg's next of kin could not be located, but the attorney appointed to his estate. It's located a will written weeks prior, leaving all his belongings to his psychiatrist. The identity of the psychiatrist has not been released due to privacy concerns. Yet another sad end to a life. as it's far too common here in the sprawl. That might be something we can go on. What's up here? Autopsy records. Alright, first off, Sobotico was found overdose on half a dozen different sedatives. There were anti-anxiety medications were also found in his system. Based on mutilate, possibly self-inflicted. Identity could not be confirmed, merely due to the disfigurement. Had to check dental records to confirm. No next of kin. Large puncture wounds were found in several places on the body. Possibly large bore surgical needles. Body had been decomposing for several weeks before the landlord noticed the smell and called the police when no one answered the door. Keep being weird. Okay, is that it? Guessing that is it, then? Yep. There's what we know. Our DNA evidence belonged to a dead man, whose death was never explained. He worked with chop shops, which fits with the living guy that you met. The news net says he left his estate to his psychiatrist. Maybe find out who this psychiatrist was will give us our next clue. My gut says we can deck into the medical board's records and reverse track to find that just doctor. You in? Alright, let's look into it. Okay, there we are.
Attacker.
Metal records. Records. Records file for located. Yeah, records are. Particularly repeated truth and energy stands out from the rest. Child suffers from chronic depression and social anxiety, most likely caused by his physical abnormalities. In many cases like this recently, the outbreak of changeling children being born. He had born. Physiology. Seeing there is no telling what sort of brain functions are affected. Tried a series of sedatives last year that seemed to have no effect. upping the dosage. Data missing or corrupted, contact administrative pro. Okay. The file is quite large and takes well over an hour to read through. The final entry, however, most significant, is written by Dr. Henry Holmes. Silas has overcome significant mental disorders and no longer goes through periods of violent episodes. Latest medications have proven especially effective, but I believe that being treated by another elf has significantly impacted his treatment. Unfortunately, my efforts to maintain an emotional boundary with him have proven challenging. He is bonded to me in an unhealthy and frankly an unnerving way. Hero worship exhibits itself in the form of mimic speech patterns and adopting my dress. For this reason, for the health of the patient, I am assigning another doctor to his case. Inform him of his next, at his next session. Name now, Dr. Holmes. Let's keep going and find out where he works. Your ass over here. Effect nitric attack, that is. Okay, fucking missed that. It's located Henry Hollings Holmes, MD, PhD. Views and parts. 2045-2054. Psychiatrist in residence, Mercy Mental Hospital in Snohomish, Washington, UCAS. 2040-2045. Clinic physician, Mercy Mental Hospital, private practice. Her employment status, Dr. Henry Holmes currently holds the position of chief psychiatrist and administrator at Mercy Mental Hospital, Snohomish, Washington, UCAS. Meanwhile, go back and you focus your head and try to set on which world is the real one. Traditionally, you're saying, blah, 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 blah. Oh, Gunner, what do you got?
Just in time. We got a host of new toys in for from the supply back east. Back for first, still smelling of their mother's gun oil. Maybe there's something in this batch that you'd be interested in.
Is 14. Painter, man. David looks almost as tired as you do. Tell that this case has gotten under his skin like it has yours. Any luck in that?
We found a exact match for DNA, but it was linked to a dead shot proposition by the name of Silas Forsberg. Now I have my theories, but what do you think is going on here, Lady S? There's that still possibility. Seemed pretty sure that when we got here that it did. What about Silas' autopsy report though? Anything stand out? Good catch. That matches up with something I've seen runners try. It's easy enough to find a body shop that'll make a replica set of teeth for you. Find some schlub off the streets no one will miss. Drop the teeth and throw the heat off your trail for a while. Luckily, never been that desperate. But why would he need to go to these lengths? Police records have something linking him to a different crime. We didn't see any evidence of that. And he left his estate to a psychiatrist, right? Why would his DNA wind up at the crime scene, though? Is he posing as a doctor at a previous murder site? Thoughts became Dr. Holmes? He replaced the real Holmes. That's probably whose body was they found inside his apartment in the first place. Dr. Holmes' employment records have him as an administrator at Mercy Mental. The picture on his file matches the person we saw downtown. Same person his DNA belongs to. All the evidence points to him being your killer, whoever he really is. Please pay him my respects. I always find that high caliber round. Get the metric up. You should clear hire some friends to go loading for bear. So I loaded a ton of valuable data from these Lone Star Matrix nodes. Here's your cut.
Runners and head to the hospital. New armors. Right, take a look. See what we got. Which one am I wearing again? Okay. Track armor 2. Alright. Power and HP. Douche. All right, there we are. New threads. I don't know what you got, buddy. Just power bolts. Lightning explosion that also does 1 AP ongoing. Shaman stuff. Fireball, yeah, fuck, take that as well. Boom. Ashprey, heal, flamethrower, armor,
mana bolt.
The bolt's 8. That one on. 12, that was 9. And do fireball. All right. Where are you, lady? I'm not one to talk. You look like track prey. There isn't much I can do for that. Medical supplies. All those. And one of those as well. We got phosphorus grenade. That. Good. That. And at that one and that one. All right. All right, let's see here. Silver technologies, base, replacement limbs, adds 6. All right, magnification. Had to hit. Everywhere causes essence loss. This affects the magic rating of your character. Its magic is equipped to essence run down. Very important for passive. Okay. I'll take this one. One spell has been unequipped and sent to your stats because max spell slots have been reduced from 5 to 4. Alright, that's fine. Got some. You're looking for runners again, I'm a guy, just street service only. Yeah, hold on an hour real quick. Ooh, 24, okay, that's Is that, range. That. Some quickness. All right. Okay, which one's like a flamethrower, lightning bolt. And armor's well off, and put our boot. And ball lightning. Alright. Yep, good. Alright. I actually have to go to the bathroom real quick, so be all bail. Alright, I'm back. Alright, let's hire some crewage. Not even sure what the fuck I'm supposed to be doing. Deckard kinda sucked. Let's get, zero? I'll definitely take you then. You're a fucking Johnny boy. And take you. Yo, rigger operates. Yep, I'm good. Welcome, ma'am. What business brings you to Mercy Heart Mental Hospital? Here to see Holmes. Dr. Holmes. Ah, new customer. Please wait in the common room up ahead. I'll notify the good doctor. Yep. Steel here? Doesn't recognize this in the... Oh, okay. Never mind. It's just over here, though. Box up. Probably was playing time from 40 years. Alright. Hey lady, have you seen Josie? I know, right? I haven't seen him in days. Dr. Philip told me not to worry about it. Says I worry too much. But who am I supposed to play chess with? Donnie over there can't suss more than match four. Well, he's big. He's got a big gold ring. Doctors let him keep it when he got here. Sometimes he lords it over us. I'm sure if I had a ring like that, I would do the same. Says he won't be the one playing for the Screamers in the Super Brawl years back. He's the next brawler. The next brawler becomes over around here, sure. Not too rough for Josie. Says he went whole seasons without any injuries. He was usually playing outrider though. Will you at least help me look for him? I have this key I swiped off the day guard to keep a close eye on us. You could have a peek in the infirmary and see if there's a record or something. You might just be in a cool off room and won't tell me. Okay, I'll be right here if you do. Hello, stranger. You look new here. Are you new here? Name's Donnie. That's my name, Donnie. D-O-N-N-Y. I knew I didn't recognize you. I know everybody in this place. Everybody, well, everybody on the first two floors. No, not on this floor. Only us common ones are allowed up in the cafeteria. You're violent. You have to eat in your own room. Donnie's face blanches. I don't think you really want that. Not really. Right here, you don't want to attract the attention of the doctor. Stay quiet, life is much easier. Much easier. I saw something interact with him. Blood, yep, alrighty. That's severed arm. Severed arm lies next to the zip body bag. Arm looks human and appears neatly severed. Yep, there's a large gold ring on the end of it, so it's probably the good end of the bag. Put the heavy ring off the cold finger and feel it. Weight in your hand. Side is engraving. It reads Screamers 2048. Yep. I don't know if it'll, Trivet if you have no way of playing back this at this time. The cart is strewn with gruesome tools, motorized saws. Patient information for C. Dawson is open at the on the cyber terminal. Medical. Date of birth, height, weight, occupation, knowledge is known, medication. Reasons for staying, post-traumatic stress disorder, status disease. Patient had undocumented cyberware in the left arm, as well as multiple pieces of shrapnel in various locations. Complications would likely arise if transplanted to another host. The rest of the body is in excellent condition and can be used to improve other subjects, as well as fulfill some custom requests. Alrighty. Chopping people up, I sees. So, did you see anything? They're dead, but I just saw him. You know what happened to him? I mean he, oh god. Well, thanks for your help. Noise of a scratchy piece and blast through the room. Attention, Lady L. Please report to the North Hall. Meet with the administrator. The elf standing before you may quite possibly... Yeah.
Good day to you. How can I help you? I am Dr. Holmes, yes.
Man stresses the word doctor, flash of anger in his eyes. But if that's how you want to play it, Dr. Holmes, I have reason to believe you're involved in the Emerald Ripper killing. I know you killed the real Holmes, and I know you're running around town carving up parts people for parts. Good racket. You had going here, but you got sloppy with your kills. Now the Ripper's trail leads straight to your door.
My word, such a violent paranoia. It's a pity. What should I expect? This is a place for broken things, after all. And you are so very broken. Yours.
There was something pick up there. Speaker crackles to life. The voice of Dr. Holmes begins to blare from it.
Attention all personnel. We have a dangerous patient loose inside the facility. Subject is a female elf, but may be coordinating with other violent offenders. Use all necessary force.
This character from the screen. Alright. Halls of disrepair. Good samurai, what you got?
take out that violent criminal as well. Search, alright. Ah, the intercom begins speaking as soon as you approach. Holmes must be watching from somewhere.
You don't understand, do you? This is a place for broken things. But only by further breaking them can they be remade. And so we must break you.
Okay, and in there. Nice. Go ahead and head on out of theirs. Get on up, buddy. Magic. Healer-ups. Whoa.
down there.
Get that motherfucker.
Yeah. All right. Wrong flash. Contains a gate key. All right. Everyone up here first before going there. Another encounter at home continued.
Someone once told me that I was a broken thing, but he also said I could remake myself. He wanted to break me down so I could put myself back together again, and I did, but only after I broke him. I could remake you as well. What wonderful twisted thoughts must churn in a mind such as yours. But I'm more inclined to use you for parts.
steaming that ass.
Two dares.
Heal you up real quick. Over. Something over here. The tribute player holds a collection of personal diaries. Some of the video files are missing.
Got some cut out chips in last week. Tried them out on the patients with violent flashbacks, hoping it would at least mellow them out some. It was like night and day. Once the chip was installed, all of the psychotic breakthroughs were blocked. Miss Yuskin has gone 4 days without attacking the staff or herself. I was walking to the organ grinders downtown, and there was some kind of event happening at Mega Media. They had a puppet there from Maria Mercurial's label with a persona fix chip installed, making her an exact doppelganger. They were just using her to hawk some SimSense re-release Mercurial live show, but it gave me an idea. The cutouts, the body modifications, and my healthy supply of patience, I'm perfectly set up to be a Bunraku Fixer. If I can find a supplier for Persona Fix chips, I could sell full service Bunraku, even program the behavior trees. Found a buyer for the first Bunraku. A man in the barons offered me 20,000 nuyen for the female troll I've been modifying. He likes them big, he says. All that's left is to arrange delivery. Says he could put me in touch with some more buyers if I'll accommodate special orders. These morons live more lives already over anyway. The least they could do is line my pockets.
Get this motherfucker.
Another enum crackles at your elbow. One side blow would offer a few moments of blessed silence, but this is also a rare chance to get word in the good doctor, who greets you with more of his chittering laughter.
You are a persistent one. A fine specimen indeed. Few friends for a face such as mine. Though I have one associate I would be happy to introduce you to. Pedazo, subdue them.
Order that monster.
There's on fires and, that beauty. Slow his ass down. Heal real quick. Really? You missed? You missed again, really? Mage, actually. Flame. Run over there. Here's. Do Let's see here. Mana blast. Alright, fucking reload. Go get him, birdie. Really? All right. Fucker taken down. Heal yourself again, because I do need to keep using the lads. Got a health. You just stay down back there. Upstairs. Shoot. Got him. Holmes drops to the ground. Light in his eyes fading fast, but something keeps the shriveled husk of his soul stuck. His mortal coil for a few minutes more, moments more.
This is a place of broken things. I remake them. She asked me to remake her.
Man, just one more laugh, his glazed eyes rolling toward a workbench across the way.
He was playing both of us.
Points, experience this creature's ability to operate in dangerous situations. Then with a final bloody whimper, the Emerald City River breathes his last. As to just that, alright. Holmes' workbench falls somewhere between corner slab and medieval torture device. It's decorated in the many colors of death, littered with the instruments of that trade. One side there is a leather-bound journal stuffed with uneven pages. The other is a hawk set kit. Small screen still glowing. Beneath the bench is a rolled sheaf of paper held closed with a tight link of surgical tubing. Okay, skim the journal. Leafing through the pages, you find few intelligible entries. Holmes may not have been a real doctor, but his handwriting certainly fits the stereotype. Stuffed in the last few pages is a copy of a disinterment order from a local cemetery with the graves occupant marked as Melinda Waits. Holmes is still logged in, granting you access to his currently loaded files. Prominent among them is a hospital report from a donor program. It lists the organs besides the names, the vital statistics of the recipients. Your eyes catch Sam Watt's name beside the entry for liver. Also on the list are the Ripper's other known victims, along with several others may have shared in the same fate. Large sum of Noonan, which can easily be transferred to your account. Wait. Unfurling the large sheet of paper, you discover a diagram of the human female form, rendered to an impressive level of detail. It appears to be a blueprint for making Holmes' very own monster. Alright, what we got over here? What are you guys up to? Chip's lie is still fresh, the open wound pink and wet and lured, voice drips, innuendo, but his eyes say nobody's home.
Well, hello there. Did you come to play? Forgive me, I'll tell you anything you want. I'll do anything you want. I'll be your little playmate. Fire name.
Dissembled in a standard config, face of a schoolgirl, body of a stripper. You need some thick beer goggles to miss the work she's had done.
Anything good?
Upstairs bank, yeah, okay. Anything else? Nope. Alright. Perhaps, as you approach the exit, you realize that Shannon lingers quite a few steps behind. Looking back, you see that she is half-turned, looking pensively toward the horror show of Holmes' lab. Finally feeling your eyes on her, she faces you and raises her hand in a proud, almost defiant manner. We have done much good here tonight. We have removed two vile creatures from this world, and so ended a growing shadow they cast upon the city. Our paths crossed and joined. We did this thing together. Now here our paths must divide. And I'm sure I could use your help with what I must do next. A distant cry of pain echoes down from somewhere above. Young shaman pauses to listen to the tortured sound. There is still more work to be done for both of us, but that must be done differently for each of us. I am here to find justice for my brother, and that has been done. Spirit can now find rest. There are other victims of the Ripper, both alive and dead, who still struggle to be at peace. Many of them are here in this place, filling the halls with their torment. I cannot leave them behind. Spirits have something else in store for you. A different path. You must finish what you've begun. You must confront the first evil that fostered the one we have just ended.
suppose I could respect that. Thank you. Thank you for everything. Because of you, my brother's killer has met swift justice, and justice of the only sort such a man as Holmes deserved. Death. And now set to the task of healing those he has left behind. For every madman we face here tonight, there are a dozen innocent souls, crying out in need. Spirits of the departed will also need help in passing. For us left here, they may come like those we met in the hangar. They all deserve my help. When they enter that room behind, back there, they will have no thoughts other than thoughts of promotion. The Ripper in mind, my brother will be forgotten, along with all the other victims. But so too will I. That will not be a problem. But sure or not, Shannon's confidence in very presence seemed capable of making it true. Good luck to you, Lady Elf. I hope you may find the same justice for your friend that I found for my brother.
Yep. Get on out, tears.
You know, square that news, the only way it's lived. Haven't made it anywhere else since I heard about it.
Kinda clean.
And Clean is talking with Cherry Bomb and Miss Kabuto when you walk in.
We were there talking about you, little lady.
And they were City Ripper. I remarked that you tracked a serial killer to a mental hospital.
Johnny Clean told me where you were going. Oh, my. We have been waiting for your return.
You're right. I should have kept my mouth shut. I should know better. Just that we have a personal stake in the Ripper murders.
We each have our reasons for wanting to kill the Found. Sam was a regular here, and his loss has been felt, regardless of his shortcomings. The whole sprawl has been shaken by these killings as well, the randomness of them. No one knows if they'll be the next, or what the killer might take from them. I admit that the killings have hampered business as well. I'm sorry, but it is true. It does not help that Sam's body was found down the street from here. Even my regular customers have been loath to venture out with a killer on the loose. I tell us, Omae. Did you find the person responsible for the Ripper murders?
Someone's pulling strings of a serial killer?
It sounds more complicated than I suspected. The assignment was killing specific people to have specific parts, all the transplant organs came from the same donor. Sam's mother looked like he was putting her back together. The three are silent as the nude sinks in. So Sam had an organ transplant from his mother, then the Ripper killed Sam and all those other people just to reassemble Sam's mother. I've sensed a cause and effect in this. Coyote and Jake Armitage just left here to attend Sam's funeral. I'm told that there will be a reinterment ceremony for his mother as well.
Like your sister has something to do with it.
Hang on, I saw Sam's sister when she was here the other day. She was a cop and they come by as they come, but I can't imagine a lady like that behind a series of murders. There's gotta be something else going on. It's clear that you must go to the funeral to talk with Jessica Watts, Lady Elf. Of course. She raises her hand and the conversation stops. Wait, before you go, there's one thing you did not tell us, Lady. Where is the Emerald City Ripper now? Hi, that is good. And I'll, upgrade my character. Go with quickness. Read that. Combat. Well, AR. My whelp. Alright. And, yes. Save and end the stream here.
That sounds good.
Oh, that was good. We got rid of the fucking, serial killer. That's all well and good. And I didn't die this stream. Well, that's a plus. Guess the next course of action is gonna be finding out who's all behind all this shit. Wonder how long this game actually is though. I know it was crowdfunded, so like I don't believe it was terribly too long. Because the other two in the series, I believe, were just like initially like DLC missions that they got expanded into their own games, I believe. Which I will be playing, of course. I'm very much enjoying this. But for now, go ahead and end the stream and I'll see you in the next one. Laters.